Hey guys, it is Arika Misha, and today I am doing a serious video, but you know, my personality just comes through all on its own. But today I will be doing a requested video. I do have a few of my subscribers that requested this video. I'm not gonna say it was highly requested, like I got 500k subscribers, but anyway. A few of my subscribers did message me and they did ask me if I could do a budget video. Basically, you know, my opinion on, you know, budgeting and, you know, what I do when I do my budget, all that other good stuff. So let me make a disclaimer before I start this. I am no accountant, I'm no financial guru, but what I am speaking from is my experience. So that's all I have for you, is my experience. That's all I can ever give you, is my experience. And that's good enough for me. So anyway, like I said, just giving you guys what I went through, things I went through. So let me first start off by saying I have not always been on a budget. Nope, wasn't always on a budget. I had to learn life and experience and things that I went through taught me to say, hey girl, you need a budget, you're doing too much. I mean, there was a time in my life before I started budgeting. I was just working, spending, working and spending, working and spending, working and spending. And it got to the point where I was spending more than I was making. I was putting it out, spending it, but what I was spending wasn't coming in. Wasn't the amount coming in. I was spending more than what I was making. It just got to that point. And that was me being comfortable. Oh, I work, just spending, spending, spending. But no, it doesn't work that way. You can't spend more than you make. That just don't add up. Just don't add up. But through life, through experience, I had to learn, girl, you need to be on the budget. You need to have some type of financial control of your life. So at that time, it was just me and my first daughter. You know, I just had one daughter at the time, you know, being a new single mom, you know. And I was just like, okay, you know, I'm just gonna do my thing. I work, I make money, I can spend. But then once I start realizing that, hey, what's going on? Girl, you're spending too much. You spending all that? This is how I say it. Girl, you got champagne taste with root beer income. Oh, that's still funny to this day. I told myself, I said, girl, you got champagne taste with root beer income. It's not working. You're spending more than what you have coming in. So, hence how I got on the budget. Because you know what? It got to the point where I started struggling. Like, wait, ain't got enough money to cover all the bills. Yes, because you're just doing what you want to do, girl. It don't work like that. Don't work like that. If you bringing in $500, you can't spend $1,000. That don't add up. So anyway, just speaking from my experience, guys. So I had to learn how to get some self-control as a single mom and get myself on a budget. And I said, okay, girl, you gotta do better. You're a mom now. You gotta do better, boo. Gotta do better. So, and that's the thing. We should always strive to do better. Want more out of life. Not even material things, you know? But you want to grow and you want more material things. You want to grow spiritually. Because y'all know I live for God now. So, don't forget that. I got to put that in there. I got to put that in there because I'm telling you, there were some days when I didn't want to stick to that budget. I had to pray and say, God, please give me the strength to stick to this budget. Please give me the strength to stick to this budget because this ain't working. But also too, I had to go to God and pray too when them bills got real tight and I ain't have enough to pay for them because I was spending. See what I'm saying? How it all comes together. So anyway, guys, so let me, I did read, if you guys see me looking down, I wrote down some key points because I want to make sure I discuss some things from my experience. Just want to discuss a few things and want to make sure I cover a few key points. All right, first key point is your income. Is it less than your monthly bills? Is your income $500 and your bills are $1,000 a month? So you already know your income is less than your monthly bills. So see, things are already uneven. Your income is 500 and your monthly bills are 1,000. So see, you've already got yourself uneven. And I'm speaking from experience. That's where I had myself. And that's what made me realize, okay, you're spending more than what you have. You're spending out of the budget. I wasn't on a budget, but you're overspending. You're spending more than what you have coming in, and you got to get it under control, and you got to get some self-control. Because having a budget, you got to have self-control. If you don't have self-control, it's going to be hard for you to stick to that budget. And I'm telling you, I know from experience, I did not always have self-control. I did not. There were times when I would do the budget and wouldn't stick to the budget. Oh, I want this, I want that. I want this, I work hard. I want this, I want that. But yeah, you work hard. You know, people respected that fact that I worked hard, but have some common sense. I had to have some common sense. Like, girl, get it together. Get it together, sis. Get it together. And that's what I had to do. So, like I said, your income, is it less than your monthly bills? So, if yes, what can I do to make it better? Either make more money. Of course, you know, you got to make more money to pay them bills. You got to make more money. Or cut back on your bills. Examples: promotion at work. Do what you gotta do. Work hard. Apply for promotions at work. That's gonna, you know, help you make more money, bring in more income in your house, so you can, you know, so you'll have more money to pay your bills and maintain your household. And this is from my experience, because these are the things that I said to myself. Okay, so it got to the point where what I was putting out was more than what I was bringing in. So I said to myself, okay, so now my bill is higher than what I'm bringing in. So I got to do something. So here it is. I said, okay, well, I'm going to work hard. I'm going to apply for a higher position, you know, to make more money, you know, that'll help me maintain the house and pay these bills and get the things that I wanted, you know, like, you know, my little wants, my little things that I needed, things that I want. Because I'm telling you something, at the end of the day, if you got $100 and your light bill $100, and you want to go buy something for $50, nah, that $100 for your light bill, boo. You can't do that. Okay, just, you know, talking about me. Anyway, so, or you know what you can do? You can also pay a bill off. And I said to myself, you know what? You know, like, when I was dealing with my budget, I was like, okay, well, what can I pay off? What can I do? We're going to get into that. All right, just want to make sure I'm making some key points here. All right, so that's just, you know, some examples, some things that I put myself through, saying, okay, now here it is. My income not matching my what I'm spending. My bills ain't matching what I'm making. So I had to either, you know, work hard, let's get this position to make more money, or, you know, pay some things off and cut back on some things, you know, like the extra spending, cut back on groceries. I'm telling you, one of the things that I learned is couponing. I'm telling you, changed my life. I'm talking going from spending $400-$500 a month on groceries to only spending $100-$200 because I coupon. I'm telling you, that extra $200-$300 a month, that's a bill. A couple of bills. Just telling you, that's why I got into couponing. I was like, hey man, my grocery bill, what can I cut back on? What can I do? What can I do to make it better? Especially, you know, I'm struggling. What is it that I can do to make it better for me, to make it more comfortable for me and my kids? You know what I'm saying? What can I do? I'm a single mom. I'm trying to make it happen. What is it that I can do? You know, you got to figure out things that you can do to help make it better. Well, you putting out less money out of your household. And I said, you know what? A friend came to me and she's like, hey, you know what? She's like, I'm going to a coupon class. You want to know? You want to go? I mean, this is about what, 5-6 years now? It's been a long time. And I was like, I don't know about no couponing. I ain't got time to be couponing, girl. And she's like, we gonna learn together. Let's go. Let's see what we can do, you know? I was like, okay. So I went to the couponing class, learned all about the couponing. I've been couponing ever since. Saving my coins ever since. Ever since. And you know what? I also have couponing classes. I teach other people how to coupon. You tell you something. You get that knowledge, you share it. Don't get that knowledge and keep it to yourself. Don't be selfish with it. Help other mothers out. Help other people out. I've taught men how to coupon, women how to coupon. There's all kind of people that want to know how to coupon. And the first thing they say to me, oh, I don't want to learn how to coupon because it takes too long. Hey, you better learn how to save money. That's what you better do. Anyway, okay, that's another whole video. All right, so let's get back to our budget. Okay, so number two, You need to make more money than what your monthly bills are. That's just common sense. I was like, okay, I need to make more money. I gotta make more money than what I'm bringing in. Hello, if my bills are $1,000 a month, y'all know I'm just making this up. If my bills are $1,000 a month, I need to bring in more than $1,000. Hello, that's just common sense. Bills $1,000, I can't be bringing in $500. Cause see, I'm always stay behind. I'm constantly struggling. And that's what it was at me. I was constantly struggling. And I said, hey, I gotta do better. I gotta do something. Exactly. That's my point. You gotta have your income to the point where you're making more than what your bills are. That's just it. That's just basic. That's basic. You gotta make more money than what your bills are. That's just basic. And if you're at that point like I was, where I wasn't making more money than my bills, like I said, I had to learn. I had to learn how to bring my bills down, cut back on things. You know what I mean? Cut back on the groceries, learning how to coupon, cut back on the cable. Let me tell you something. I got rid of that $135, $145 a month cable bill, and I got Roku. Paid $30 for the Roku stick, and that was just one-time deal, $30 for the Roku stick, and the only thing I needed was internet. So I took my cable bill from $135 a month to $35 a month. Because all I need is the basic internet. That's all I need. It was $35. $32, $35 with tax, whatever. Took my cable bill from $135 to $35. Because remember, with the Roku, all you need is internet. I bought the Roku, paid for the internet. I paid $35 a month in the internet bill. Ain't got no cable bill. Uh-uh, boo. I got Roku now. See, these are some keys, some little things that you can do to cut down on your bills. Because see, now at this point, I was working hard, working, trying to get promotions, doing what I gotta do to make more money, but I still had these bills coming in. So that's why I had to cut corners. See, once I started couponing, see how things are off now. This is my income, and this is my bills, and this is my my income. So once I started cutting down on the grocery bill, learning how to coupon. Notice how that's coming down to meet the income. And then, when I cut that cable bill out, things are starting to come together now. See, it's little things like that that you can do to cut down on your bills. You gotta go through your bills, each one of your bills, and say, okay, how can I make this less? How can I make this better? What can I pay off? You know what I mean? If you got a bill that's $300-$400 and you paying $25 a month, go ahead and pay that chunk off. Are you paying, you know what I'm saying? Because you barely can make the payments, $40, $50 a month. Go ahead and pay that thing off so you ain't got to worry about that. That's a bill, a monthly bill, gone, bye, poof, gone. So just, you know, talking out from my experience. All right, so you need to make more money than what your monthly bills are. That's just common sense, y'all. Come on now. You can't have, okay, I already said that. I already used that line. You can't have champagne taste with root beer income. I wrote that down, y'all, because I want to make sure I told y'all that. You can't be having no champagne taste with no root beer income. Boo, boo, you got champagne taste. Better go make that champagne money. Who? Forget that. Better make that. What? Better make that money. You want this, you want that. You got to work hard. You got to make the money to have it. That's how I was. I was like, girl, you like this, you like shopping, you like going on Amazon, you like doing this, but you better make that money so you can pay your bills, not struggling with your kids. So bills came first before all that other stuff. Now I had to learn that too. This is why I say self-control. You gotta have self-control. If you ain't got it, pray for it. Because I didn't have it and I had to pray for it. I ain't have it. I said, God, I need you to help me because I'm spinning. I said, God, please help me. Please help me do the right thing, God, please. And God said, hey, you're a mother. And God said to me, when you struggle, your kids struggle. When you ain't got, your kids ain't gonna have. And y'all know, if y'all don't know, I don't play with my kids. They are number one. Y'all know what I mean. My kids come first. They are number one. And I'm telling y'all, I'm not saying I was a bad parent, you know, but when we do things, when we struggle, our kids struggle. Things that we do affect our kids. So listen to what I'm trying to tell you. Not trying to judge nobody, but I'm just talking about me. So here it is. If I'm not making enough money, what happened when my kids need something for school? What happened when they need school clothes? You know, they gotta eat, they need food. So here it is, if I'm falling short, they're not gonna be able to get the things that they need because I'm falling short. This is what I'm trying to say. Things that we do affect our children, affect our kids. That's why we gotta make the right decisions. We gotta be smart about what we do. We gotta make the right moves. When you have kids, I'm telling you, when I had my daughter, I was hanging out with my friends, going to the club, sitting outside the club, doing my thing. When I had my daughter, my first daughter, all that changed. I was like, nah. I ain't saying I became a grandma. I'm not gonna say that. I'm not gonna say that. But my priorities changed. I was like, nah, I'm a mom. Now I gotta get it. I gotta do right. I gotta do better. And then when I started getting like doing what I wanna do, spending the money how I wanna spend, things that she needed, she couldn't get because I ain't had the money. And I said, hey, wait. I'm a mom, my child come first. Here it is. Girl, you better get it together. Do better. Do better. And this is just, you know, from experience, y'all. Long time ago. Years ago when I was younger. Years younger. Just, you know, telling y'all about what happened in the past and how it made me who I am today. Y'all, my battery going dead. Hold on, y'all. I'm going to come back. Because we're going to finish this. Okay, guys. I got my battery changed. Anyway. So, got what I was saying, y'all? God dog it. But anyway, I just had to get it together. Okay, so anyway, you keep overspending, you will stay in a hole. You keep overspending, putting yourself in debt, you know, you're just gonna keep putting yourself in a hole. That's all I got for you. You know what I'm saying? You keep doing it, and that's what I did. I kept doing it, and I kept myself in a hole. And I said, you know what? I gotta get a budget. I gotta get some self-control. I gotta do better, you know? So, all right, so my number three, must have self-control, must be able to control your spending. Know when to spend and when not to spend. I was just talking about that. Know when to spend and when not to spend. Let's see. Practice staying within your budget. Practice staying within your budget. You get into that habit where you're staying in your budget. You're spending what you're supposed to spend. If you got a couple extra dollars, okay, you know how much extra dollars you got to spend. That's it. If you only got 50 extra dollars, that's all you got. Don't be trying to make that 50 turn into 150. No, 50 is all you got. That's all you got. And I'm telling you, over time, as I stuck to my budget, I was like, man, this ain't working out. This ain't working out. Man, I ain't got but $25. I can't do nothing with that. You know? as time went on, once you get that budget, once I got my budget in line, things got better. Things got better. So, all right, so let's see. The next thing I wanted to say. Okay, practice staying within your budget. If you know you have your light bill set aside, don't go spend it on something else unless it's like an emergency. You know, if I got $100 and my light bill is $90, you know what I'm saying? I'm not gonna just go spend this $100 on an outfit or a purse or just something that's not an emergency. Like if you got an emergency, you have to take your child, cause y'all, we know how it is now. You gotta take the kids to the ER, then you gotta get some prescriptions, then you gotta get some medicine. Come on now, we as parents, we know things happen. Something that's an emergency, unfortunately, you know what I'm saying? Hey, it's an emergency. I gotta do what I gotta do. And the light bill, if you don't have it, just try it. You know what I'm saying? If I didn't have it, I just try my best, you know, ask somebody that I was close to. You know, just keeping it real, y'all. Just keeping it real. Don't sit here and take that $100 that's for your light bill and go spend it on something. Just because you see a purse you like, you see a shoe you like, you see something on Amazon. you see something on Amazon you want to order. Nah, come on now. I'm telling you, I went through this. This is what I experienced. I experienced this stuff. $100 on a light bill and I'm going to spend it on something I want, something I see. I'm telling you, I went through this. I'm talking to y'all from experience. I'm not judging nobody. I'm judging and talking about myself, what I went through. And there has to be a point in your life where you want to do better. And I got to that point. I said, I want to do better. I want to be better because I want my kids to have. I want them to do better. I want them to see me doing better so they can want to do better. You know what I'm saying? Okay. All right, y'all. Okay. I'm serious. This is when I'm talking about coins, about my money. I'm serious. I'm serious about my money. I'm going to play about my money because I work too hard. Okay. You work hard for your money. I'm not working to just pay bills. No, I don't want, I did that. I'm telling y'all, I did that. Work, just pay bills. I know how that feels. I know how it feels. Work, just to pay bills. I'm just working to pay bills. I know what that's like. I know how that feels. You have to do, you, there has to come a point in your life where you want to do better. You want more out of life. So you know what? You do what you gotta do. You do what you gotta do to make that happen. You want more, you wanna do better. Okay, I'm gonna do what I gotta do. I'm gonna work harder. I'm gonna work hard to get that promotion. I'm gonna cut back on spending. I'm gonna cut back on this. I'm gonna cut back. You do what you gotta do. You wanna do better. And that's exactly what I did. You get tired of struggling long enough, you'll get it together. You struggling and you see people doing better, then you get all judged and get mad. I'm telling you, I did it. Got all mad, got all just, oh, she did, he did, da-da-da-da-da. Do better. Don't get mad at nobody else. Do better. And I say, you know what? Well, I'm getting mad. Well, I'm getting jealous of them for. I just need to do better. I need to do better. I can't worry about what you're doing. I can't worry about what he or she doing. I got to do better for me and my kids. At the end of the day, that's what it comes down to. Don't come down to nobody else. What nobody else got, what they ain't got, and what you ain't got, what they got. Don't compare yourself to nobody. Don't compare yourself to nobody. Never do that. Never do that. And I did that. That was the worst thing I could do. Don't compare yourself to nobody. Don't do that. Don't do that, because it don't make it no better. It don't make you feel no better. You know? Don't do that. Just do better. You want better? You want more? Do better. It's on you, ain't on me. And that's why I say, you know what? I was blaming other people, and I say, nah, it's on me. I'ma do better. I'ma do better. So, all right, y'all, let's move on. Okay, so this is gonna be a two-part video. This is gonna be a two-part because I get to talking. That's why I wrote down these key points, because I knew I was gonna be talking in between. So this first portion of the video is gonna be these key points that I wanna talk about. Key points of a budget, you know? And then the second part is gonna be where I actually did like a little fake budget. I already did it. I already wrote it down. It's gonna be in the second part of the video because I don't wanna make this video too long. So I wrote like two little fake budgets so we can look at and so y'all can see, you know, a good budget, a bad budget, a budget that needs help, you know? I'll show y'all. All right, let me get through with my points. I'm almost finished with my points. All right, something else. Let's see. Okay, all right. We already discussed that about using your light bill money. Okay, so I got two more points to make, y'all, and I'm gonna end this video. This will be the first portion. All right, so my next point, if you're gonna have a budget, plan to stick to it. Don't just say, I'm gonna budget every month and don't do it. Don't waste your time. Cause if, I'm sorry, but, and that's what I had to do. I started budgeting and then I was like, nah, I don't feel like budgeting this week. I don't feel like, I'm just gonna do what I do, you know? I don't feel like, I'm gonna just do what I do. And you know what, that ain't helped me. That hurt the situation. That ain't helped me cause I just got myself back into the same situation I was in. This is what I'm talking about, y'all. I'm telling y'all, it was a struggle for me. It was a struggle. It was not easy. It will not be easy. I will not sugarcoat it for you. Because I went through it. I went through it. Back and forth, back and forth. On the budget, off the budget, on the budget, off the budget. And when I got tired of struggling, you know what made me straighten up and stick to a budget? And I've stuck to a budget ever since. And let me tell you something. Whether you have a budget or not, I'm just keeping it real. A budget don't make life perfect. Because you can have a budget and something can happen. Like your car breakdown. You gotta spend a couple $100 on that. I'm just keeping it real with y'all. Life happens. We all know life happens. Come on. But a budget can have you to that point where you know what? You got money saved. You got money tucked back. So if something happens to your car, you got a couple extra dollars to handle that. You ain't gotta stress out. You ain't gotta stress out about that $300, $400 I gotta pay the mechanic. Cause I got $2,000 saved up. See what I mean? It wasn't always like that, y'all. But you'll get to that point in your life. I'm telling you, I know. You just gotta do it. Okay, back to my point, y'all. Okay, if you're gonna have a budget, plan to stick to it. Don't just say you're gonna budget and you don't. You're just wasting your time. Have to be committed to your budget. That's the only way it will be successful and help you. For an example, say I'm writing in my budget book. But say you're gonna write in your budget book, but you don't, and you skip it. I wrote that down, I just discussed that. Stick to your budget. Do your budget. I do my budget every 2 weeks because I get paid every 2 weeks. I get paid bi-weekly, they call it. So my budget is set up bi-weekly. I'll get into that with y'all in the second half. But all right, so commit yourself to that budget. Stick to that budget. And you know what? Like if 1 month you don't do it like you're supposed to do it, next month make sure you do it. Say, oh man, I ain't do it last month. I gotta do it because I don't wanna fall behind again. I don't wanna get in that trap again. So, you know, don't beat yourself up. Don't beat yourself up. I know, don't beat yourself up. All right, so, okay, my last and final, number 5. A budget is designed to keep you on track with your bills ahead of the game, not behind the game. is designed to help you, you know, keep up with your finances, keep yourself financially stable. It's designed to keep you ahead of the game, not behind the game. It's designed to help you maintain, not put yourself in a hole, you know? Okay, it may be hard at first, but as time goes on, it will be easier and you will see the benefits. Example, when you have extra spending money, it feels good. Like I just said, prime example, say something happens with my car and it's gonna cost me $500, cause y'all, we know how it go, y'all. And it costs $500, oh man. But you know what? The old me, oh man, who I'm gonna get $500 for? I ain't got that. But you know what? Getting myself together, getting my life together, the new me, hey, I got a couple things tucked back. See, it don't bother you. It don't bother you as much. Cause now, I don't care how much money you got tucked back, you still mad to be paying that mechanic bill that, don't do that now. I don't care what you got. You still be mad to get that mechanic all that money now. So let's just keep it real. See, that's why my thing is I work hard for my money. So you know what? I'm not gonna just waste it. I'm not gonna just be silly and just get myself back to the old me where I was in a hole, couldn't pay my bills right. Nah, I got a taste of this budget, and in the beginning it was rough. I was doing it 1 month, not doing it for 3 months, doing it 1 month, not doing it for 4 months. I'm telling you, and there were times when I ain't do my budget for a whole 6 months. Yeah, I regretted that. And finally, when I got tired, when you get sick and tired of being sick and tired, you say, hey, and you see your family suffering, you're gonna say, hey, I gotta get it together. And that's what I did. I said, hey God, God help me, please God. See, I was like, here it is, I'm serving a mighty God, rich houses and land, but why am I struggling? If my heavenly Father is rich, houses and land, God can bless me with anything, if he can do all that, why am I struggling? Why I ain't got nothing? Because of me. It's me. I'm not gonna blame nobody else. I said to myself, where am I falling short at? Spending when you ain't got no business spending. Period. Period. Spending when you ain't got no business spending. And I say, you know what, God, I want to do better. And I got fed up. I got sick and tired. And I prayed one night and I say, you know what, God, I gotta do better, man. I gotta do better. This ain't helping me. I'm not getting no better. Things ain't better. I'm stressing out about this, stressing out about that, stressing out about this. Can't do what I need to do for my kids. Keeping it real, y'all. And I said, God, I need your help. I gotta get some self-control. I gotta get to this budget. I gotta get to it. And you know what? Stuck to my budget. And I've been sticking to my budget now. Wow. I've been sticking. I'm not talking about on and off again. Nah, I ain't talking. You know how people say they've been sober? I'm just keeping it real, y'all. I've been budgeting and been sticking to my budget for about a good, man, my oldest is 25. I'm gonna say about 20 years now. Good 20 years now. Because when she was little, around that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I was still doing what I want to do. But once she started getting into the whole out of elementary and middle school, and she needed more things for school, and I was like, and that's when I started to see more where I was falling short. So yeah, I've been sticking to my budget about 20 years. Telling y'all, it ain't easy in the beginning. It's not easy. It's not easy, y'all. It's not. Pray God to give you strength. God to be there for you. God to help you, because he helped me. And y'all see, I stay on Amazon. Y'all don't do that. Please don't judge me. Y'all, I'm sticking to the budget. I'm sticking to my budget now. Y'all know I learned my lesson. Sticking to my budget. See, that's the thing. When I started my YouTube channel, I had to include that in my budget. Cause see, that's you. When you start a YouTube channel, it's an investment. Cause you ain't getting paid by YouTube in the beginning. So see, you're investing your hard work and money. You ain't got no investors coming up to you. Ooh, you starting a YouTube channel? Let me give you some money. You ain't got that. See. So in the beginning of your YouTube channel, I realized, when I did my research, I was gonna have to invest. So you know what I said? Okay, invest. That's money coming out of my pocket, out of my bank account. So now I have to include that in my monthly budget. And that's what I do. I have a YouTube budget. I have an amount in my budget for YouTube. That's it. That's what I spend for the month. If I see something, now boo boo. If I'm if I set an amount for my budget for YouTube, that's what it is. Hey. If I've already spent the budget, the monthly budget, YouTube amount, gotta wait till next month when I get a fresh budget. Gotta wait. So, all right, guys, I'm gonna go ahead and end this because this is gonna be about a good 15, this is gonna be about a good 20, 30 minute video. I'm gonna try to, I ain't gonna edit it, y'all, because I don't wanna cut that out because I feel like everything I said was so important, you know, and from my personal experience. So, this is gonna be about a good 30 minute video, y'all. I hope y'all, you know, follow it, look at it all the way through. So, let me go ahead and cut it off so it don't get any longer. So, it's gonna be a part two. I'm gonna go ahead and film part two. Right now, I'm gonna cut this off and then I'm gonna go ahead and film part two so we can get more into like a hands on budget, like let y'all see the budget that I created. So, all right, guys. This is Arika Misha. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget, this is part one. There will be a part two to this. Basically, I don't know what I'm going to title it. Something about a budget. Y'all know me. I just, whatever God, whatever I get, that's what it's going to be. So, all right. This is Arika Misha. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Follow me on all my social media at Arika Misha, guys. And don't forget that knowledge is power. Thanks, guys. Bye.